The first transaction that attorneys need to know how to record is how to record receiving client retainer payments, also called client deposits. What happens in your books and records when we receive a retainer deposit from a client? Well, the cash in your bank account obviously goes up because you just got paid, and the recorded amount in your unearned retainer fee account goes up because you got paid in advance and did not yet earn the money. What happens when we receive retainer deposits regarding the client's balance? Well, the balance of the client goes up because at the moment they pay, you owe the money to that particular client. Please note, we will not use the undeposited funds feature in QuickBooks. We will assume all clients' payments are directly deposited into the bank account and that checks received are immediately deposited into the bank account. Please watch the QuickBooks banking videos to understand how this is done. It's very simple. It's a simple preference that you can change in the preferences window, but it will explain more if you actually watch our banking videos. If you know QuickBooks, you can use the undeposited funds feature in your own company when you actually do your own books and records if it's something you feel comfortable with. For example, let's imagine on January 1, we receive $6,000 from client Alan Arby for 6 months retainer in advance, and he paid us with check number 84, which was immediately deposited into the bank account. Let's take a look at how to record this transaction. From the icon bar, click Payment. Now, the date of the payment was January 1, let's assume that's January 1 of 2017. The client was Alan Arby. He gave us check number 84. So check number 84. Now, the money was not deposited into undeposited funds. It was instead deposited into the Chase bank account. To get this pull-down menu, you have to change the options in the preferences window. The payment amount was $6,000. Push tab on the left of your keyboard. Now, this is all the information that you need. There is a memo field way down here at the bottom of the screen, bottom of the window that you can't see. And you might want to use the memo field very often to describe what this money is for and how long it's for. But aside from the text that you type in for yourself, you should click Save and Close. And now, at the moment you click Save and Close, you have to print a retainer receipt or some kind of documented proof that you can give the client. So we click Print Credit Memo, and now we click Preview, because in a real situation you would print it, but because I'm showing you this on video, I click Preview. Notice it says Retainer Receipt, and it has only the column headings and the columns and the information that you customized for your clients when you made the retainer receipt in the previous video. Now, let's click Cancel, and now let's check what the results are in your books and records. The trial balance shows now there is $6,000 in the Chase bank account, and now there's $6,000 unearned by Ross that he owes to his clients in future services. Now, this is his general accounting information, but let's take a look at the specific client records. In the client balance detail, which is really the customer balance detail, you can see that Ross owes Alan Arby $6,000 of future services that went into unearned rent on January 1 when he received the payment. Now, obviously, $6,000 a month, $6,000 for 6 months in advance means that Ross basically earns $1,000 per month from Alan just being on retainer. That will be an important point in the following video. But in this video, let's do another example. Let's imagine on January 1, we received $7,200 from Betty Boop, the client, for 6 months retainer in advance, and she gave us check number 717, which was immediately deposited into the account. Obviously, that means Ross earns $1,200 from Betty each month just being on retainer for her, regardless of what services he provides. So how would we record Betty's information? Well, again, we click the payment icon and we put the date is still January 1. The client in this case is Betty Boop. And of course, she gave us check number 717. Now, the money amount she gave us was $7,200. Look to the left of your keyboard and push the tab key because that will save the field without closing the window. This is all the information we need. Again, in a real situation, you would come to the bottom of the window and type in the memo field all the details about your arrangement with Betty regarding this particular payment. We click Save and Close, and QuickBooks asks us to print the credit memo, which we will click. And in this case, it's her payment receipt. In a real situation, you would print it, but because this is a video, I will preview it for you. And you can see this is the retainer receipt. Let me scroll up. This is the retainer receipt for customer Betty Boop for the $7,200. And you can customize and adjust this receipt to suit your needs on your own time. Let's cancel this because we're not going to print. Now let's again look at the trial balance. Now the total cash in the bank is up to $13,200, but you can see we have not earned any of that. All of that $13,200 is unearned retainer fees for now. Now our third client, Candy, has a slightly different arrangement. January 5th, received $2,400 from Candy Charles for two future court appearances, and this is the check number that she gave us, and we immediately deposited it into the bank. That means that it's going to be $1,200 per court appearance sometime in the future. That means that this is unearned retainer fees. So again, click payment. This time we choose Candy Charles. She gave us $2,400. Actually, she paid us on January 5th, so you have to be careful about the date. And she gave us check number 222. Of course, down at the bottom in the memo field, you want to describe things as best you can. Click Save and Close. Print credit memo, which is really Candy's rent receipt. And now, after you click Cancel and the transaction is saved, when you look at the trial balance, you see that the total unearned is $15,600. If you want an explanation why you owe $15,600 to the clients, you can see that the customer balance detail, which you could also call the client balance detail, shows at this moment you owe Alan $6,000 of future service, you owe Betty $7,200 of future service, and you owe Candy $2,400 of future service, and that's why the total of the customer balance detail is $15,600, which is the same as the unearned retainer fees and the trial balance, $15,600.